Today I'm just west of Delisle and I'm hanging out with Dwight, who is a beekeeper, and we're talking about how these bees help farmers.
I'm an apiarist, which is a beekeeper. Today we are going to take honey from the bees.
Honeybees depend on healthy crops, and healthy crops depend on honeybees. In fact, it's said that one third of the food that we eat is made possible thanks to pollinators like honeybees. Canola is just one of many crops that provide a great source of food for honeybees. These bright yellow flowers hold plenty of pollen, and the nectar is perfect for honey production. In turn, the canola benefits from the buzzing visitors, with research showing a measurably higher yield when pollinated by honeybees. We also benefit from all the bees' hard work in the form of tasty honey, and I got the chance to try some of the freshest honey possible. Okay, so my initial thought, there's almost no taste.
It's very mild.
Yeah.
And the honey that we produce in the Three Prairie provinces is basically the premium honey of the world.
Interestingly, and it makes sense if you think about it, the taste of honey varies depending on what type of crop the bees gathered nectar and pollen from. So what crop makes the best tasting honey?
Well, I would say clover alfalfa is number one.
A single honeybee hive is home to upwards of 60,000 bees. And in a good season here in Saskatchewan, one hive can produce more than 80 kilograms of honey. In order to produce just half a kilogram of honey, the bees must fly over 88,000 kilometers. That's more than 1.5 times around the world. If you're interested in getting your hands on some of this delicious honey, you can find Dwight at the Saskatoon Farmers Market on Saturdays.